Hey guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Beast! I'm YouTube famous now. Available in 2000 BC. The album, Dad AF. Rock on, Gold Dust Woman. Okay, let's get right into this video. I know y'all want to just hear what I have to say about the whole Jeffree Star video. I was actually taking a nap, and my friend called me and she goes, it's up. And I was like, okay, I guess I'll go watch it and film a video. So Jeffree Star just posted this video. It is called Never Doing This Again. It 5 minutes in, it had 219,000 views. And it's just him sitting there, very posed in front of the camera. And him just kind of explaining that the video that he threaded out yesterday on Twitter and on Snapchat, that he's not going to make that video anymore. That the more that he thought about things, that this had gotten really, really deep, it had gotten really, really dark, and that he was going to say, enough is enough, I'm not gonna do this anymore. The responses in the comment section were very, very mixed. I was really surprised. When I looked at it, hold on a second. It currently has 151,000 likes, 9,300 dislikes, and 487,000 views. And I'm sure this one will go viral too, because everybody wants to hear what Jeffree Star has to say about this. Like I say in all of my videos, thank you to all of the new subscribers out there and to the OG Wolf Pack that's been around forever. Thank you for watching my videos. I love to make videos. That's why I have 5 channels, my blog that's like a podcast, and the other channels. But I love for you guys to have a conversation in the comment section below. Be kind, be compassionate, be considerate, be classy. That's what I always say. We can have our opinions, and it doesn't mean we have to fight with each other. We can, you know, disagree with each other, agree to disagree, whatever. But we can have our point of view, and I think that's important. And I really do want to hear what you guys have to say, because I was so surprised by just kind of like the mixed responses. And I have to tell you that after watching this video, the total, like, it seemed like the responses were split in two. The responses were either, oh my God, thank you so much. This was the video that everybody wanted. You know, you're so classy. You really handled the situation really, really well. I love you, stan you forever. It was like all kind of that. Or it was like, this was BS. You didn't tell us anything. You didn't address the issues because you don't have receipts, yada, yada, yada. And I'm kind of like somewhere in the middle. I'm kind of like, yes, I think the video was handled very well. I think it's Jeffree Star's attempt to kind of stop things. But at the same time, there's been so much said at this point. There's been so much kind of like indirect, like threatening as well of like what I'm going to expose. There's been a lot said, right? And not just in one tweet, not just in two tweets, in direct messages, in Snapchats, and whatever, from the whole lot of them, you guys, not just Jeffree Star, but all of them, okay? They've, all of them at this point, had things to say. Videos are being deleted. There are videos being deleted by some very interesting YouTubers out there indirectly involved in all of this. And when I went in to go find out what video is, I was like, this is interesting. So there's the story that's being presented to us, and there's the story that's behind the scenes. I'm just gonna tell you, okay? And I'm kinda just waiting to see what comes out before I talk a little bit about some of that stuff, because I think that this was the smartest move for Jeffree Star. For me, I felt like, okay, I was really impressed with how he handled things. Jeffree Star could have got on video and he could have just said, I just don't want to do this video. I don't want it to go any. I'm not going to contribute to any more of the ugliness. I'm not going to contribute to any more of the darkness. I'm just not willing to do that. I know you guys want the receipts. I have the receipts. I have receipts, but I'm not going to show them, okay? I'm just not going to take it there anymore. He could have just done that, right? But he didn't. And what he did was he went in and he addressed the tweet to Ian. He addressed the other tweets. He talked about how it had taken him back to a dark place. Somebody in there said, it was interesting, they said, because he said all day yesterday he was in this really dark place, and they said at a movie premiere, which I thought that was kind of an interesting observation. I hadn't even thought about that. But, I've lived through days where I had to go attend to things, and I just, like, in my head, I was, like, in a really, really dark place. As a person, and Jeffree is not, you know, that I am aware of, that he does not identify as an addict or an alcoholic, but I have been sober for 24 years. You know, there's that part of me from back in the day that is still, I don't like it, that part of me. And so when he said that, I related to that, because there have been times in my life in the last 10 years that old Peter has come up. I don't like that. Like, I don't want to be that person today. I'm not that person, but it does come out, you know? And so I have to be very, very careful of that. The thing is that I think often it's kind of like you have to think through what you put out there, because so much has been said at this point that now, you know, people are really wanting to know, well, what about all these allegations, okay? Like, you've called him a predator more than once. You have said all these things. You said you have horrible, gross, disgusting receipts, okay? That he, or that you, you know, he was going to show us disgusting things, and that he was going to, you know, gross behavior. He used those specific words. Backed Toddy saying that, I mean, these are serious, serious allegations. To just get on video and say, yeah, I'm not going to address them anymore. If you want me to address it behind the scenes, I will do that. It makes me kind of wonder what's going on behind the scenes. Do I think that it was handled well? Yeah, I think it, you know, honestly, two things. I think it was very, very smart for him to do this, because at least on his level, and he's gaining a lot of subscribers off of this, on at least on his level, it cleared him out of this and it moves him on and he can go back to doing what he was doing, which I think was smart. Quite frankly, I don't think he should have ever gotten involved in it in the first place. But that's just my two cents. I think he thought he was backing his friend Toddy. For what reasons? We don't know. So this is kind of his exit, I think, from all of it. At the same time, you know, everybody is saying that Toddy's video is PR. Everybody's saying that James' video is PR. This video is PR. I mean, let's just be for real, okay? And let me tell you why. Because although it was eloquently said, although he took a lot of responsibility, it was, from a public relations point of view, a really, really smart thing to do, okay? Because whatever he said in a video, if James had more receipts on him, James was gonna, he had already shown his cards. He was gonna come out and he was gonna say something. God knows what he had on Jeffree Star. So I think Jeffree thought to himself, when does this end? Or is this gonna be the battle royale? I mean, is this gonna be just this endless war? I don't want that. It's not good for me. It's not good for Nathan. It's not good for my brand. It's not good for James. It's not good for any of us. Although I think Jeffree is really worried mostly about his world, which I would be too. So I think he was like, okay, to end this, I just can't address these things. I can't put them out there. I can't say them. I do believe that actually that Jeffree has receipts of something, okay? They have been friends for too long. They've had too many conversations that I have to believe that Jeffree has some stuff on James. James has stuff on Jeffree. I think they all have stuff on everybody, okay? And that is so sad to me. Can we just talk about that for a second? Where you keep receipts on your friends, where you keep and save. I don't save text messages like that. I mean, my good Judy and I, we share some stuff in text messages, okay? I am not screenshotting that stuff and saving it. I just can't even imagine. I mean, I really cannot imagine having a friendship where you save stuff like that. I can't, okay? Like, that trust level right there is like on a whole, and they live in a different world. So, you know, God love them. They live in a different world, and maybe that's what they have to do. But to just have all this, I don't know. It's very sad to me. And it's not just one of them. I'm not pointing the finger. It's all of them. It's all of them that has receipts here and this, and they call it receipts, you know? It's like, so you look at your friendships with, like, receipts. Like, it's crazy to me. So, yeah, I thought it was a brilliant move. I thought it was a brilliant business move, and I also thought it was very smart. And I don't think that he was dishonest in the video. I think that he got in the video, and I think he owned the stuff that he did. And like I said, he didn't have to do that, okay? He didn't. Jeffree Star can do what he wants to do in a video, and people are going to respond to, he's very smart, you guys, and people are going to respond to it the way that he wanted to. It's like, you know, when you apologize to somebody, if you say to them, like, if somebody's mad at you because you hit him in the face, right? And you say to them, I'm sorry that I hit you in the face, okay? That is so much different than saying to somebody, I'm sorry that you're upset with me for hitting you in the face. Did you get it? Like, they're two completely different things. Jeffree's smart. He knows how to word things. But in this video, he didn't. He was just really transparent and came out and said, I shouldn't have done this, I shouldn't have done that, and I shouldn't have done this. The only thing for me is that in watching all of this, and the thing is that James is getting a lot of heat because of a pattern of behavior, okay? It's not just one isolated incident. It's a pattern of behavior. So for Jeffree to come out and apologize for the tweets yesterday or whenever he did them, you know, the other day, and then this tweet to Ian, I mean, but we also saw direct messages. We also saw text messages. We also saw, there's a pattern of behavior there. There's a pattern of behavior for all of these people. Quite frankly, sometimes I look at all this and I think, are these like who we're looking up to in the world? Like the way, anyway. I do agree with Jeffrey. It's gone to a really, really dark place. I think to perpetuate it any further would have been not smart for Jeffrey, and I think he knows that. He was also losing subscribers. People weren't trusting what he was saying. He wasn't losing a lot. It wasn't going to affect him greatly. I think he lost like 40 or some thousand. I mean, which for most of us is huge. You know what I mean? There's people that are like, yeah, that's 6 times, 10 times the size of my channel. But, you know, for Jeffrey, I mean, that's not a lot. But I think that what he did was he just, like, stopped it right here. I mean, now for James to come out and make a video would make James look stupid. You know, if James came out now and made a second video saying, well, let me tell you about Jeffree Star, it would look like if he was belaboring the point. It would make James look stupid, okay? What he also did, and listen, Tati's still losing subscribers off of all this, so I don't know what her move will be. I have a feeling Tati won't do anything. So, you know, it's interesting to me. The one thing I will say is that Jeffrey and Tati were kind of over here, but this video didn't help Tati at all. This video makes Jeffrey look very good, but it doesn't make Tati look any different, especially on the heels of her saying, I stand by everything I say. It almost kind of makes her look not so great. So, you know, I don't know what Tati will do. I think Tati will take some time off, and then I think she'll go back to posting regular videos. And then I think, you know, James will go back to posting regular videos and doing tour. I think Jeffrey will go back to posting regular videos. And I think things will get back to normal. It'll be interesting to see if, like, Gabriel Zamora or somebody comes out and says something. You know, if they come out, if he or Nikita or somebody. I mean, Gabriel seems to always have to have something to say in all of this, right? So if he comes out and says, well, Jeffree Star did this because he didn't have any receipts, or Jeffree Star did this because James is doing this, or James has this on him, or whatever. That would be, you know, like, that would be a wrench in the whole plan, right? So, I don't know. It's interesting to me to see what happens. You know, one of the things that I screenshot this one comment off the video, and the comment said, I love Jeffrey, but this video makes it seem this whole drama was planned behind the scenes and that it didn't go as planned. This isn't us wanting tea. It's us wanting to know who's the one that really is lying and knowing who we shouldn't be supportive or supporting. Kind of disappointing. And, you know, it's interesting to me because I really agree with that statement to some degree. You know, it's like all of this has been said by the people involved, okay? We've been sitting here as bystanders watching all of this. Now, we've invested our time and energy in watching videos. We've invested our money in the products that they support and the products that they put out and the products that they have their names on it. You know, we support them in their sponsorships. We support their careers. We are the one in the 16, 10, and 14 million. We are the one, okay? So when you hit subscriber, that number goes up one. When you unsubscribe, that number goes down one. You are that important. But we don't deserve answers now that all of this has been stirred up by them. Now we don't deserve to know really what the truth is. Like I said in my video yesterday, I hope to some degree they go off camera, they work things out, and then they come back on camera. The other thing is this, is that you can say you're sorry all you want, but there have been some very, very serious allegations that have been made. There have been some very, very serious words that have been used that no matter how much they want to sit on camera and say, I'm reactionary or I'm this, or, you know, Tati saying, I didn't want to hurt James to this level. You know, those are things that James is never going to, like, shy away from. Those are things that if you Google James Charles' name 10 years from now are still going to be out there. And those are things that other people have said, not just James, not just Tati and Jeffrey. There's a lot of people saying that. So I don't necessarily think that this whole thing is over. I do agree that everybody kind of needs a break from it. It's overwhelming. I can't imagine living right in the middle of it. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens next, you know? I think that kind of what we're getting from all of them is, at this point, they just kind of want to walk away a little bit from this. And they don't want to continue to address it on a regular basis. So I don't know. You know, at this point, you know, I said I would wait until Jeffrey's video was out to you know, reserve all judgment. I will tell you how I feel going forward for all three of those people involved is that they've made a lot of claims. They've made a lot of statements. They've made a lot of apologies. They've said a lot of things and then they've taken it back. They've said, you know, on and on and on. At this point, I think that there is a lot of receipts or evidence, so to speak, on who all three of them are today. Going forward, I will be basing any judgment that I have on any of them on today. Not on 8 years ago, not on 6 years ago, not on 10 years ago, not on 4 years ago, but today. Because this is who they present themselves as. So if they want to get on video and they want to say, like, this is how I feel about things, and in 2 months from now, we see the same behavior as before, well, then I think that that's showing us who their true character is. And that is how I will be basing it going forward. Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Are you over it? Do you wish that Jeffrey would have come out and said something and shown the receipts? Do you think it's because he doesn't have the receipts? Do you think it was an eloquent apology video or an ending to all of this? You know, I do think that it is kind of a nice way to end all of this. I really, really hope that James Charles doesn't come out and say something and tweet something out and stir this up again. Let's just kind of let it go right now, you know? Let's just let it be what it is. And I guess we're gonna have to sit back and see what happens next. And if it doesn't, and the dust clears, then y'all are gonna be hearing about Jaclyn Hill's new brand that just came out. So anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I love you, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.